Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to share with you 15 very effective tips on how to make your child interested in studying. So as parents, we all want our kids to study and excel in each and every aspect of their life. But sometimes we may set some unexpected or unrealistic expectations which may backfire. So it is very important for us to check what all expectations we are setting up to our kids are realistic and they are achievable. So the first very important tip is sit with them while studying. Make sure you also take part and sit with your child. If the child is very young, you have to study along with him. If the child is a little bit older, you also sit with him doing your work, and as and when they get some doubt, they feel that you are there right beside them to pitch in and ask doubts. And the second important tip is discuss studies. As parents, it is our responsibility to understand what all subjects they have. We also should discuss with them what happened with each and every subject in that particular day at school. So this will help the child to be more alert in the class, because they know that coming back home you'll be asking them what has happened with their particular subject. And we also should know their favorite teachers, just to understand the interest of child. And the third important tip is to create a study environment. Most of us see parents making the kids sit here and there, maybe in the TV room or maybe in the dining room or maybe sometime outside. See, kids have extremely low attention span, and it is very important for us to make sure the studying atmosphere is totally distraction free. There should not be people moving around, there should not be any other talking, because more than the study matter, that will get into their brains. And it is also important that you should see their siblings are not doing any other activities like watching TV or playing around the kids, because that also will lose the kids' interest towards studies. So make sure they have a set environment for studies so that the child could give his 100% attention for studies. So the fourth tip is lay stress on learning process but not the grades. Though grades and marks are very important to understand and analyze the child's progress, it is equally important that you should not consistently focus on the grades. It is also equally important that you should make sure the child is learning and progressing. So it will be a good idea to shift your focus on learning process rather than on grades. If you make sure the learning process is 100% correct, grades will automatically come. You have to focus upon aspects which are making it difficult for a child to understand a particular subject. And the fifth idea is be on your kid's side. When a child is not scoring well in any particular subject, we suddenly ask them, what happened with you? Why are you not studying properly? What's wrong with you? Rather, take your child's side, sit with them and ask them, what is getting it difficult for you to score marks in this particular subject? Understand their perspective, why it is happening so with them. Always, it should not be like you are the advisor for your child. Rather, you have to be in friends with your child so that they will also show interest in sharing things with you as on why it is happening so with them. So the sixth tip is to make a study schedule. For example, as we know, anything that is systematic will go a long way in life. As we have a study schedule at school, it is also equally important for parents to make a study schedule at home as well, so that the child will know what has to be done once the child gets back to home. So it is always important that you have to include study time and also writing time. It is not just that they finishes the writing work and it's done. No, you have to give time for studies as well, as equally as the writing part, because if you can make sure what they have learned for that particular day can be revised once again in that particular day itself, it will be very easy for a child to learn things quickly on that day itself. And if there are any doubts, it will be easy for them, since you're sitting beside them, you can clarify it then and there itself. And the seventh important tip is talk to the teacher. For example, kids sometimes might not show interest in one particular subject, or they are like extremely interested in some other subject. That is because of their teacher. Few teachers create a very good impact on kids, and sometimes kids may not accept teachers for whatever reason. So in that reason, it is very important as parents to speak to that particular teacher, and it is our responsibility to work along with the teacher to make sure the child will overcome all the barriers and do well in that particular subject. And the eighth tip is follow your kids' style. So many kids have different styles. You should know what your child's style is. Like, few kids understand things quickly, by visual presentation. Few kids may understand things quickly if their parents or brother or sister explain it to them verbally. Few kids understand things easily if they listen it from their teachers. And few kids understand it very quickly and easily if they read by themselves. So you have to understand what is your child's style and follow accordingly. And the next tip is help them learn from their failure. So it is equally important for a child to face failures without which he cannot enjoy success. So as parents, it is our responsibility to make them go through the ups and downs of studies. That is when they will understand how they have to overcome the fear of failure. Generally, when the child is not doing well at school, as parents, we still ask them why it is so happened and all, but you have to sit with the child, discuss with him, asking him, encouraging him, it's okay to be a failure for now, because now that you understood what has to be done for the next time to succeed. So you have to always incorporate positivity in your child and make them learn from their mistakes. And the next tip is make your child more involved when it comes to studies. For example, if you are planning to buy a study table for your child's reading, or it can be as simple as stationery or any books, new books or anything, make them a part of their learning process, because when you take them for shopping all this stuff for themselves, they feel that they are valued, their opinion is valued. That is when a child will show even more and more interest in learning, and he will own that, because that is something which he has selected by his own, and now that he did it on his own, he feels that it is his responsibility to study. As parents, we always do the best for our kids, but in this process, most of the parents will keep ending up yelling at kids or scolding them or lecturing them for not getting the best results. So this will not help the child in any way, because verbal bashing will ultimately end up the child in not showing any interest towards studies. They may not show it up to you, but that is the reason they have within themselves, that they will not like you scolding in front of peers or friends. This is what parents generally do, comparing with their siblings or comparing with their friends at school. When things like this happen, they feel so low and they really don't want to study, and that they don't even want to tell to parents. So it is always important that we have to discuss with kids rather than scolding them or manipulating them and lecturing them. Next is acknowledge all the achievements. When we set a study routine to a child, it is very important as parents to acknowledge their achievements. For example, you ask them to read a particular lesson for the day, and if you think that the child has done the best, then you can say, wow, that's great, how could you do this? So you can appreciate them, because everybody likes appreciations, and you can also reward them. I am not asking you to bribe the child. If they say ABCD, you don't need to give them a scooter, or if they say some 1, 2, 3, you don't need to buy them something which is very expensive. Rather, reward them for whatever they have done. That will motivate the child to do more and more. The next tip is reading habit. Inculcating a reading habit will always help the child to show more interest and to be more inclined towards the studies, because a reading habit will eventually make the kids enjoy the studies as well. So for this to happen, as parents, it is our responsibility to set a particular study routine at home. Maybe it is equally good that if you all can set a library at home, you can pick up your books, sit in that particular place and have a reading time all together. And you can also share the book's knowledge to your family members. The next tip is be firm and disciplined. This is very important. Most of the times, parents are not serious about the kids' studies, and still we expect kids to be very studious in class. We expect them to score good grades at school and all. But how do you think it is possible without we showing them interest, without we giving them a track to progress and all? So it is very important as parents that we should check how well we are supporting our child in the learning process. Teachers are there at school to help them to do at school, but who are there for them to do at home? They need a mentor at home as well, and as parents, it is our responsibility to guide a child at home as well by setting some targets, by setting a schedule for their studies and writing process and everything. And the next tip is listen to them and help them. Create such an environment where kids feel that study is a part of life, equally playing is another part of life. And if sometimes they really don't want to study, you can let them go. And the next day when they come back, you can ask them to study, and you also should remind them, I allowed you to go and play because you said you did not want to study on that time. This will make them realize that we are also giving chance for a child to think. So they will also give a chance to think about what you have asked them to do. So this is how you have to build a good rapport with your child to make sure they will study effectively rather than discouraging the child. You should not ask kids to study right from the morning till evening, because you have to allocate a time and you should tell them you have to study in this particular time. So I hope these tips will be very helpful for you to make your child show interest and incline towards studies. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel. Take care. Bye.